Next month in Southern California, the Long Beach Museum of Art will open all at once, a 25-year retrospective of artist Tristan Eaton. Described as an urban pop artist, Eaton's work moves between guerrilla street art, commercial design, civic installation, and fine art. And as NewsHour Weekend's Christopher Booker recently learned, Eaton has long lived outside of convention.
For this mural on New York City's Fifth Avenue to work for the artist Tristan Eaton, he says it must successfully cater to two audiences.
I want to paint a work of art that has impact when you drive by at 40 miles an hour and you just get a quick glimpse. It has to work that way. But I'd like there to be more for the person that will spend more time with it and engage with it and learn about it.
There are many places across the globe where this can happen. In New York City, in Berlin, Los Angeles, Paris, even Guam.
And when you drive through a city of cinder blocks and brick and concrete and drab grays and browns, and you see a giant pop of color, it's a reminder that anything's possible.
For Eaton, this possible was born of a childhood spent relocating. As a child, he moved from Los Angeles to London and then Detroit.
Being a new kid all the time is, it does a powerful job on your brain, you know, that's for sure. I feel like the greatest thing I learned is the hustle. You know, finding a way to adapt and overcome and reinvent yourself and adapt to changes.
But at 16, Eaton's reinvention started to coalesce. His family's move to Detroit was a fortuitous stop for a kid falling in love with graffiti. The city's abandoned buildings provided an open canvas, while the breakdown of a once mighty industrial city, a narrative for his developing aesthetic.
And the abandoned buildings were a canvas for me to go off. And that's been a big storyline in my life, is giving myself as many tools as possible so I can get the ideas out of me in a way that does them justice.
After high school, Eaton moved to New York to study at the School of Visual Arts, where slowly his career began to take shape.
You know, I worked in a factory, I worked in a restaurant, I worked as an art mover. I did everything I had to do to get by, man. And there was comfort in knowing, like, it doesn't matter, because the thing that means the most to me is my art, and that will continue no matter what else is happening.
In the early days, his career took shape not with murals, rather toys. In 2002, he co-founded Kid Robot, a designer toy company where Eaton would design what's known as the Dunny and the Money, both of which now sit in the Museum of Modern Art's permanent collection. But it's the mural work that has caught the rest of the world's attention. What does public art at the scale that you work in, what does that offer a city and a community?
Well, to be honest with you, it's extremely hard to quantify and so subjective. But when I go to paint in a city like Detroit or cities that don't get as much public art funding or much attention, people can feel heard, they can feel valuable, they can feel unforgotten. And that alone is extremely important. You know, every so often we'll paint a mural and then that mural becomes an intrinsic part of that community and a landmark, and no one will ever let it get painted over. And that's how I know we've done a good job.
Do you find that as you've gained success and notoriety, does that anxiety, for lack of a better word, anxiety to understand and to fit in with the space you're in, has that remained?
No, because I had to grapple with that early. I had a lot of years with no success and no money. And what helped me through all of that, it still helps me to this day, which is that all the external accolades and where you fit in the world and how successful you are has nothing to do with the quality of the art you're making. And I found that it was easier for me to focus if I just realized that all I had to do was put my head down and do good work. And eventually the world will come if the work is good enough.
From the commercial to the inspirational, the world did come for Eaton. And in May of last year, SpaceX wanted to know if Eaton had any interest in his work leaving the world.
There was some empty cargo space in the shuttle, in the capsule. And they didn't know what to do with it, and they were thinking about sending some art into space. And did I have any ideas? What did I think?
Eaton had 1 week to deliver, his past once again informing the present.
Well, I used to have a secret identity called Trusto, and we used to fabricate fake street signs by the hundreds and put them up through cities, and they would just say ludicrous, absurd stuff just to mess with people. So I kind of have this history of working with metal street signs, and laser etching the street signs applies no paint and no extra material that could, you know, be flammable in any way. So I thought that was the method of production. And that could be turned around really fast. And the laser etching process can execute really beautiful detail.
So in addition to adorning the world's cities, Eaton's work has now been to space.
There's no rules, man. You know what I mean? Like, whoever tells you there's rules, you know, you should yell at them. There's no rules. You know, I came from a place where I didn't think I was going to have any success. I didn't think a life in art was possible. So if I met the 20-year-old version of me, I probably wouldn't believe anything I had to say. But I hope that it's inspiring to, you know, younger artists out there who probably have a hard deck of cards dealt to them right now. You know, a lot of people are struggling. And, you know, being an artist is an independent venture. You know, you don't have a union. You don't have health insurance most of the time. So I'm hoping that it's a beacon to, you know, artists out there that, you know, you just do the good work and it'll come eventually.